Hello students, now let us talk about the next point. After prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell study, we'll go for the next point, that is microscopy for the cell study. Now the diagram which is shown here, that it is the diagram of compound microscope, and through this diagram I'm going to explain all the parts present in the microscope. So first of all, it is important to know what is microscope and the different terms used in the microscopy, that is magnification, resolving power, then different types of microscopes. So let us see the important term microscope and the details. Okay, so the microscope is an optical system which is used for the study of objects which we cannot see from with our eyes, unaided eyes. So things which are not seen with the help of our eyes, we have to use the microscope in that case. So it makes us see things which are very small and which are otherwise invisible. And the literal meaning of microscope means micros is small and scope in means to see or to look, right? So the small things which we see is the microscope, or the microscope means the small and to see. Now first microscope which was designed by Janssen and Hans, and Janssen's microscope is a compound microscope. It is the first microscope and it contains two tubes which are fitted one inside the other. So it was the very first microscope which was prepared by the Janssen. It was also the compound microscope. And now see, what is the meaning of magnification? Now the magnification means, or it is equal to, size of retinal image seen with microscope divided by size of retinal image seen with unaided eye. So magnification of anything is equal to size of retinal image, means the size of our eyes, retinal image, the image which is produced by our retina seen with microscope, divided by size of retinal image seen with unaided eye. So that gives us the magnification of that microscope. Now what is mean by resolving power? The resolving power is the capacity of an optical system to show distinct images of points lying very close together. The resolving power is the capacity of any optical system to show distinct images of points lying very close together. So we need to distinguish between the two points, and that capacity of that optical system is known as resolving power of that microscope or any optical system. Now here the resolving power of human eyes, unaided human eyes, is 0.1 millimeters. So our resolving power, our eye resolving power, is 0.1 millimeters. Okay, and this resolving power depends on the wavelength of light and the numerical aperture of the objective lens. Then the types of microscopes. Which microscopes are seen? Microscopes are of different types, or they can be classified into two major types depending upon the source of illumination. The first one is light microscope. That means the microscope in which only light is used as a source of illumination. So wherever light is used in the microscope, so that microscope is classified as a light microscope. And electron microscopes are present, which are using electrons as a source of illumination. So these are the two main types of the microscopes, light microscope and electron microscope. Now in this point we will discuss about the light microscope and the very well known or very commonly used microscope is compound microscope. So we are going to focus on this compound microscope in this lesson. So light microscope, as I told you, in light microscope there are different types of microscopes, but we will discuss the compound microscope. Okay, so here in the diagram you can see the compound microscope. Compound microscope is one of the light microscope. It is a type of light microscope. Light is the source of illumination, as I told you. Light is used as an illumination source. Now why it is known as compound microscope? Because there are two lenses. Compound means there are two lenses. Namely, which two lenses are found? One is objective lens and another is eyepiece. Objective lens and another one is eyepiece. Okay, so if you see this, the eyepiece is here located and the objective which is located here, okay, which is present here. So these two lenses are used in the microscope and therefore this is known as a compound microscope, right? Next, now the objective lens is situated near the object. So wherever we put our object on the slide, so that lens which is very closer to the objective or the slide which we are putting there, that is a objective lens. And from the upper side, on the top side where we from where we see through the microscope, that lens is our eyepiece. So that is second lens which is used here. Okay, the now here it magnifies the object. How many times it can magnify? It can magnify the object 20 times or up to 40 times. And how? See, the magnification is written on the lens. How we can calculate the magnification of that lens? The magnification is written on the lens, that is 20x or 40x or 10x. So it starts from 5x to 20x. Okay. Now magnification is written on the lenses. The eyepiece, which is situated near the eye of the observer, the eyepiece is situated near the eye of the observer. Okay, then it magnifies the image magnified by objective lens, and this magnification is written as 5x, 10x, 15x or 20x. So here in this way we can calculate the magnification by multiplying the magnification of the both the lenses. So let us see it in detail. Now, as I told you, magnification is the power of magnification is obtained by multiplying the power of objective lens and that of the eyepiece. So how we have to calculate the magnification of the of this microscope? See, for example, if the power of objective lens is 20x, okay, if the power of objective lens is 20x and power of eyepiece is also 20x, okay, then the magnification which is produced here is 20x into 20x, means 20 into 20, so for 400 times it is magnifying that image. So the objective or the object which we are putting there on the slide, it will get magnified up to 400 times because we are using the two lenses, that is eyepiece and the objective, both are of 20x magnification, and therefore by multiplying these two together, 20 into 20, we get 400 times of magnification. And thus the compound microscope magnifies the size of the objective
400 times here, and it may vary from 100 to 400. So whatever lens we are using or we are setting there while observing that object, we can calculate the magnification, right? Now the resolving power of the microscope. The ability of a microscope to distinguish fine details in the specimen as a separate distinct image points is termed as resolving power. So it resolves, it differentiates the two points separately. It will distinguish the fine details in the specimen as a separate distinct images or image points, and that is nothing but the resolving power of that microscope. And this resolving power is increased by decreasing wavelength and increasing numerical aperture. So this is all about the basic concepts of microscopy, and in the next lecture we'll see all the parts of the microscope.